There to take him down.
Well, you can't play man-to-man, Jim, every single play. Every once in a while, you got to throw in the zone. That's what they did this past play. Hey, it was a good idea. It just didn't work.
Second down and 10. Launches it down the field. Touchdown. That'll close the gap. As we near halftime, that was a much-needed touchdown that suddenly gets this team mentally and even on the scoreboard right back into this game, Phil.
Changed everything, Jim, didn't it? I mean, it changed the fans, the way they're looking at the game, the coaches, the players. It's amazing. One play, and look what it did to this football game.
And Amendola's going to test the coverage here. And he's met head-on right there at the 20. Peyton Manning getting ready for this next possession.
He practiced great all week, and certainly it's carried over to this first half today.
That's right. All that confidence he gained in practice all week long, he brought it right here on the field, had success early, and it's been fun to watch.
Almost intercepted that time. Back in shotgun formation. It's Ayers with the sack.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
Gets the handle here. That's a good tackle, and that's a quick three and out. The 49ers signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. So now they'll call on Kern to punt the football. Peterson with a chance to return this one. Tackle down at the 42-yard line. That return's good for about 23.
The 49ers know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking. They get it done.
Green's playing out of position in the backfield here. Wilson's running away from the pressure. With the contact, the ball comes out.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
Wilson from the shotgun. Looking to go deep. Intercepted! Brings the play to an end. One half down and both offenses still searching for answers. We've got a defensive battle on our hands, and Larry Ridley is coming up next. All right, Larry, thank you for that from the studios and halftime. We're going to transition now. We're about to get the third quarter underway. That return's good for about 19. The Vikings offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest. Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
And Morris is stopped there.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
Boy, his head got yanked back the other way. An obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet, in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask.
Morris is tackled down after a gain of five.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Murray's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Looks but can't connect on the short throw. After the incomplete pass, it's third down. Dropping back now into the shotgun. And the catch by Alfred Morris.
This is called managing the football game as a head coach. What are you doing here? You've got a lead. It's close. It's fourth down. The short yardage. You're near midfield. Don't do it. Punt the football away. And if the other team's going to go ahead, make them drive the length of the field.
The 49ers offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think you need to try a few different ones here in the second half. The 49ers did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Now first and 10. Here's the handoff to Adrian Peterson. And Wake in on the tackle. We don't always get to see defensive matchups these days, but today it's been exactly that. Low-scoring game, and it's because both defenses have really stepped up and done their job.
Yeah, a lot of people look at games like this and go, oh, that's boring. I think it's fun to see because we don't get to see it too often. And what it does, it puts a lot of pressure on the players and especially the coaches to make decisions that are going to give their team a chance to win in a game like this.
You see the rushing numbers now, and, well, there's just not much to look at because neither team has run the ball very well today.
Yeah, really, when you look at running the football, it's not a strength of either football team, so it's pretty easy to stop them in situations like this.
Third down and 13. Wilson's on the move. Has the catch. That's his first reception today.
49ers look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Peterson. And that's a gain of 10.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
First and 10. They want to keep feeding him the football. Jenkins is there to make the tackle.
Peterson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
We're about to get the final quarter started here, partner. And this defensive battle has the feel of a game potentially headed to overtime.
Oh, absolutely. This game is so tight and the scoring is so hard to come by that I would not be shocked at all to see it go into overtime. But, hey, still a ways to go. Can both of these teams continue to play this way and not make that big mistake? That was a good idea that time by the offensive coordinator. Trying to go with the run game here in the fourth quarter when you're only down one score. Defense was ready and stops it for a short game.
Wilson's got it in the gun. Gets his feet down right near the chalk.
Jim, here in the fourth quarter, when you're down, what you want to do is just keep that football moving. That time it's a short throw, he gets a completion. Good job.
Well, that field goal gives their defense a lead to protect, and they only have to protect it for a little under one quarter.
Anytime you have the lead in the fourth quarter, it just gives you confidence. You can play knowing you have that lead. You can play free, and that's when players are at their best.
the Vikings stalled on their last drive, forced a punt. So now the offense comes back out onto the field.
Yeah, they're coming back out. They lack confidence, and I understand why. They came out, couldn't get anything done. The defense was flying around, making the plays. They got to change the tempo of this game.
And he's taken down.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback, and that time, the speed of the defensive end gets around the tackle and gets the sack.
Manning standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Ball is tackled down. That's going to be a pickup of 10.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short. Then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
Third and 10. He's got a wide open alley. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
The Vikings, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
And a flag comes out, and they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Holding defense.
The penalty is declined. That last play will hold up.
The line of scrimmage, the 48.
This game is not over, but the quarterback knows that time is short, and his team must do something in a hurry. Morris with the grab. Gains 15.
Oh, I loved it when I was a quarterback, throwing screens or throwing short passes to the running backs and watch them catch it and get those big yards. It was awesome to get cheap yards like that.
Manning's now completed four in a row. Coming out of the two-minute warning, and it's up to the defense now to hold on to this game. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. Cooks there to catch a ball, but nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown. In the final moments, they score the touchdown to take the lead late in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, it was a nice drive, and it was exciting to watch. Now, can the defense go out there and hold on to keep this game where it is?
That hurts. The two-point try is denied. The Vikings setting up for the kickoff. Peterson's going to start his return. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. Wilson's got the game in his hands right here as he heads back onto the field. And partner, he knows he's got to make something happen here right now.
Oh, I like his chances. Hey, we know he is a quarterback that can make all the throws. But this is a good offense, so there's going to be opportunities out there, and I'll be very surprised if he doesn't get it done. The 49ers just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Wilson's completion percentage, 70% on the day. And Richardson's going to pull in the bullet pass. That's his fourth catch of the day. First down, pressure on every snap now. First down and 10. Set up screen to Peterson. Breaks the tackle. Peterson's tackled down at the 39. The 49ers have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth quarter. Second down and 7. And the pass goes incomplete. Ryan in on the coverage.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
out of the gun. Launching it deep. And it's incomplete.
There's a fine line there. When you're winning the football game, what do you do on the defensive side? Well, that time, the defensive coordinator stayed aggressive, and he forces a fourth down by the offense.
Fourth down late in the game, and the coach has to go for it. The 49ers have it at the 39. Polk has the catch. Wilson's unable to come through on fourth down. And with that failed possession, they may wind up walking out of here today wondering what could have been.
They're going to be so disappointed because all year long in these type of situations, they have been very good. But that was just, it was not meant to be, and they couldn't come through on fourth down.
I am shocked they were unable to convert. The 49ers will call for the timeout. They need every second to be preserved at this point. Vikings take it from the 38. Ball is out, and it's a takeaway. He's brought down. Here we are in the last 2 minutes, and the 49ers offense takes the field, and they are absolutely in desperate need of a big-time drive here to put points on the board.
The one thing we do know, since you are behind, the defense most likely is going to be very conservative the first couple calls. So make sure you have play calls to take advantage of the fact that they're going to be very conservative on the defensive side.
Wilson set. Everybody emptied out for this snap. The 49ers will take the snap from the 40. Wilson's taking off. Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
And this is a crucial third down play coming up. The 49ers get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. What a touchdown as we near the end of this one. A long touchdown pass for the lead. In fact, that may be the game winner here, Phil.
It could be. Boy, what a show of courage and determination and toughness by the football team, and especially by the offense here in this drive.
So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure 2 extra points. Matt Prater is ready to run up and kick this football. And Wallace is going to test the coverage this time. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Vikings offense still has a chance here, Phil. Late in the game, can they make something happen?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see, Jim. I think let's look at it from the defensive side. Know the situation. If they get the ball, they catch a pass, make sure you come up and make the tackle. Don't let them catch and run and get a big play against you.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. First and 10. Out of bounds, incomplete. Rams will need to get to about the 33-yard line to give him a shot. The Vikings come to the line of scrimmage with 2 timeouts to play with. The 49ers lined up in the nickel. The Vikings snap it at the 36. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. The Vikings call for a timeout. They want to talk it over on what should be coming up, the final play of the game. Now first and 10. Peyton Manning looking down the field. And it's going to fall incomplete. Their comeback effort comes up short. Well, week one
is in the books, and one side is now 1-0.
Yeah, it's a great feeling. You know, all training camp, preseason football, and everything you work for, you come out, you get rewarded, you win the game, Jim. You're 1-0. Everything looks great.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
Come on now, just